Okay, show of hands. Who wants the D?
Nah.
I've been dying to get this D on video for you guys.
Nah, that's not it.
Y'all want to see this D?
You know you want this D.
I'm trying to expose this D. I'm sorry, I'm trying to be mature here, but it's just so hard. Okay. All right. It's time. You ready? Let's go. This video is brought to you by Bookmark.com. Bookmark's a free website builder where you can create a professional-looking website with hosting in just a couple minutes by answering 7 simple questions. Bookmark's AI engine, Ada, literally builds your website right in front of your face in less than 2 minutes, and you can edit virtually every aspect of the page once it's complete. It's awesome. Click the link in the description below or check them out at Bookmark.com. Yo, I'm Brian P. You're watching Bad Seat Tech, and today you're getting an exclusive first look at the Model D lightweight ergonomic gaming mouse from Glorious PC Gaming Race. This is not gonna be a full review today, more of a first look. I'm gonna try to answer a lot of the questions I know you have. I'm not gonna get into a ton of comparison stuff with a lot of other mice, performance stuff, how it works with my specific playstyle, etc. That's all gonna be for the future full review. For transparency, Glorious was cool enough to let me test some of the early prototypes and provide feedback for this mouse along the way. The copies that we have in-house today represent the latest pre-production samples. The Model D carries the same price structure as the O, so we've got 49 for matte and 59 for gloss, and carries the same design language that we see on the O and the O minus. So we still have holes on the top shell and the bottom plate, but no holes on the sides. Overall, the mouse is much similar in size to the Model O versus the O minus. There may be a D minus on the way, but I sure hope Glorious calls it the Lil D. So length here is 128 millimeters, 61 at the front flare, 67 at the rear, and 63 millimeters at the grip. The height at the top of the hump is 42 millimeters. If you're looking at the online measurements, that front measure of 33 millimeters is actually to the top of the scroll wheel, or about 3 millimeters taller than the Model O. It's still a low front with only like 16 millimeters from the desk to the front edge of the triggers. Despite those larger dimensions, they still manage an official weight of 68 grams for matte and 69 for glossy, give or take a couple grams on my scale. So while technically not the lightest lightweight ergo out there, for those of you who appreciate smooth sides as opposed to skeletal, this really only adds about 4 grams. So naturally people have assumed that the shape here is an EC clone. Obviously it's an ergo shape, and the dimensions here fall in between the EC1 and EC2, but the subtle differences in dimensions and curves make for a different hand feel. Even with a hand measurement of 20.5 by 10.5 centimeters, the EC1 fills my hand to the point where palm is really the only option. I can use claw if I have to, but it's not really comfortable. Whereas I can still even fingertip the D. Stop it. Partially due to the dimensions and partially because of the weight. In any grip, my fingers feel lower to the front. The hump is not quite as pronounced, left to right falloff is a little more extreme, and the less wide rear flare makes me feel like I'm in better control of this mouse. They did an excellent job with the shape and dimensions. In terms of build quality, Glorious has gone to great lengths to make sure that every aspect of this mouse feels solid, and I'm very happy to report that after some feedback and a few different prototypes, the copies I have in-house right now feel very solid. Side play on the triggers is minimal to non-existent. Pre-travel is minimal. Post-travel is minimal to non-existent. These triggers feel crispy and stable. This is even more impressive when you consider that the triggers are split from the body and not a single top shell. I'm not being nice here. I graded all these really hard, and all the footage that you're watching, I used a lot of force to get that movement. Side buttons feel really good as well. They are larger here versus the O. The front button has very minimal pre-travel and basically no post-travel at all. The rear button still feels really solid, but has a bit more pre and post travel like we normally see on the rear buttons of most ergo mice. And somehow they managed to get all these dialed in without any side flex on the frame at all. I can't get the side buttons to actuate by applying pressure to the side panel. Scroll wheel feels really good here as well, similar to the Model O. There is a little side-to-side motion like you see on basically every scroll wheel, but this doesn't affect the performance in any way, and if there's any rattle inside this mouse at all, I certainly can't find it. Watch. Build quality for me, for a lightweight, and based on what I'm seeing right here,
10 out of 10. If they can maintain consistency across all the production units, we got a winner here. A lot of the features and design language remain unchanged in terms of lighting and software, so I'm going to focus on the differences. You'll still get your choice of white or black and glossy or matte. It's important to note here that all these mice will ship out with the new Ascended cable versus the original cable. So this is the newer, thinner version. Still the same easy mod to change to a different color Ascended cable if you like, and these also aren't susceptible to the connection issue that affected a portion of the older cables. The G-Skates here are the same PTFE compound we've seen, but the small feet by themselves are different in dimension from the O's, as the bottom plate has like a different curvature. But you also have options this time around. If you prefer a bigger glide on the front or back or both, you can use these inserts here to fill in the space between, like we've seen on the G-Wolves mice. Inserts are made from the same material and are height corrected to ensure they sit flush once they're installed. The mice will ship with these included, but not installed. So it's your call whether or not you want to go that route. All right, that's it for today. That's all I can say right now. I will gladly answer any questions you have about the dimensions or physical build out or feature set of this mouse, but everything else, especially those questions like this or that, that's all gonna have to wait for the full review. If you're seeing this video, it means reservations are open now. You're paying $5 to reserve a spot. It's not a pre-sale. You're not paying $5 for a mouse. Make sure you read everything carefully so you understand what's going on. This is a great feeling, Ergo. I'm really happy to see that Glorious took their time and everything they've learned to this point to deliver a mouse that feels really well built, and at $49 or $59 represents a solid value versus other lightweights out there. I'm stoked for this one. And that's it for this time. I'm Brian P. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button, hit that sub button, and until next time, stay up.